Hi everybody and welcome back to my channel. And if you haven't been here before, I make videos all about fitness, travel, and other super basic shit. So, bienvenidos. Today, I'm going to talk about something that everybody loves, food. So, I've been getting a bunch of messages on what I eat, how I fuel my body. People messaging me all the time about, you know, I work out a lot and I feel like I'm eating healthy, but I'm not seeing any results, or I cut out carbs. Like, is that what you're supposed to do? No, you're not. Put the carbs back in your diet. You need them. Please. So when I lost the original, like, 25 pounds that I lost almost 2 years ago, I wrote a blog post on how I lost the weight. And I had to take it down as soon as I realized how wrong I was because, yeah, I did lose a lot of weight, but, like, I was insane. It was a 12-week challenge. I lost 25 pounds. I had gone down, like, 9% in body fat. What did I do? I'll tell you what I did. I worked out for, like, literally 3 hours a day. Not, like, 3 hours with some breaks. Maybe, like, a 5-minute break in between workouts. Your girl was being hit. Like 3 hours of HIIT, boxing, daily ultimate training classes at UFC. I was doing all that for 3 hours a day. Went from eating unlogged food, whatever I wanted, to eating super cut and dry food. At the end of the challenge, in order to cut weight to try and win, I was eating like 500 calories a day. And then when I was in like the peak of like my deficit, I was only eating like 1200 calories a day. And I was burning like three times that. Not three times that, but I was burning at least double that, like 2400 calories a day. I listed out my diet and saying that 1300 calories as a very active person to eat during a day was healthy. Let me tell you, it is not. So today I am providing you with a new and refreshed list of tips to abide by when it comes to eating if you want to lose weight, if you want to gain muscle, if you want to cut down on body fat, or if you just want to eat healthier and you just want to learn how to maintain and feel good. I have got your back. You're ready to learn? You're ready to learn? We gonna learn. You maybe watched a video like this before where they use all this lingo and you're like, what the heck are they talking about? I don't get it. Don't worry. I still sometimes listen to those videos and I'm like, what are you saying? Not in scientific terms, please. In English. So the first thing I want you to know on my five tips, my first tip is no one gets this right the first time. No one gets this right on the fifth time or the umpteenth time. This is something that you will have to trial and error, and that's okay. You want to learn what works best for your body. Everybody's body is different. What works for me might not work for you. I'm going to give you the foundation of what I know and what has worked in order to set a path on how to feel good, look good, and understand what's going on in your body. The second tip that I have is understanding deficits, surpluses, maintenance, what those three things mean. Don't worry, we're gonna simplify it for you. So eating at a deficit basically means that you're eating less than what you burn, and that's going to automatically mean you're going for weight loss. That's just like basics 101. It's literally math. So if you suck at math, get excited. You about to get better. A surplus is when you consume more than what you burn on a daily take. If I burn 2000 calories in a day and I'm eating 2400 calories every day, I'm in a surplus. And I might be going for muscle gain. Typically, like a good example of this is bodybuilders. Bodybuilders have to bulk up before they shred, so they will eat at a surplus. The big muscles! Sorry that I did that. I'm really sorry. Bodybuilders, they eat at a surplus so they can build muscle, and then when they're ready to shred, they eat at a deficit. Last is maintaining. Maintaining is basically eating the same as you burn. So if you burn 2,000 calories and you eat 2,000 calories, congrats. You gonna stay the same weight. How do you know how much you burn every day? That's a great question. Well, if you have a Fitbit or an Apple Watch, congrats, you're already ahead of most people because you probably already know how much you burn every day. But for those of you who maybe don't have that, or if you just want to know in general what someone your age, your height, your gender burns, you would want to calculate your basal metabolic rate, aka BMR. Basically, that is what you burn by just existing. And that doesn't take into consideration how often you work out or anything like that. It's just you being human on a day-to-day basis, chilling. We're gonna take out our phones and we're going to Google calorie calculator. And it's gonna be the one that says calculator.net. That's the one that I use, it's the best. So it's gonna look like this, and you're gonna enter in all of your information. So I am age 26, I am a female, 5'3", and I weigh a solid 138. So you're gonna click the basal metabolic rate. You can see it gives you options for little to no exercise and how many times you exercise every week, but you're gonna click the BMR option. Then you're gonna click calculate. So you can see at the top, it says basal metabolic rate, 1,335 calories a day. That's how much I burned doing the bare minimum, which is literally the story of my life. That's how many calories you burn in a day. So if I'm chilling, and that's my rest day, and I just wanna be a couch potato all day, which is totally fine, I would eat that amount of calories. That's just like a base. We're gonna go back, and we're actually gonna click how much we actually do. So I'm intense, obviously, and extra, so I'm gonna click intense exercise 6 to 7 times a week. Calculate, now we're going somewhere. So maintain weight, I've gotta eat 2,303 calories a day. That's pretty spot on. That is like full on maintains for me. When I'm in a surplus, I'm eating like 2,400 calories a day. And honestly, it sucks, it's so much food. But you gotta do what you gotta do. Mid weight loss, 2,000 calories. That's like my goal, is just like to kind of chill at 2,000, have some wiggle room if I'm going super hard in the gym or if I wanna gain some muscle. Weight loss, 1,800 calories. I would never eat only 1,300 calories in a day. I believe in healthy weight loss, not like extreme cutting weight. You know, obviously unless you're like in a sport where you need to do that, but if you're like trying to just like be a normal healthy human, don't be doing that. That's so extra, don't be doing that. This is such an accurate website. Please use it as a parameter. Ever since I figured this out and I've been using it as a parameter, it's been a lot easier for me to track my caloric intake and to understand my macros a little bit better. Which leads me to my next point. The next thing we're gonna talk about, my third tip, is understanding what the heck to eat and how much of it. This is where it gets kind of crazy, and by all means, I'm like so not a nutritionist and I'm not a pro on this stuff, but this is based on my experience. This is based on my friends who are athletes that do this stuff all the time, that like have to know this, that they have to abide by this in order for them to maintain their physique, their performance. If you follow this and you can understand this, you'll be on a good pace for success this year. I promise. Let's talk about protein, carbs, fats, and sugars real quick. I know people are dying to know if you should cut out carbs or not. So if you're active, this is what you should be eating for protein, carbs, fats, and sugars. And it doesn't matter how active you are, it's just like if you're active. Protein. A great parameter of protein is to be eating 1 gram of protein per pound that you weigh. So I weigh 138 pounds. I should be eating 138 grams of protein, bare minimum for me. Next is carbs. Please don't cut out carbs unless you're going keto. Don't cut out carbs because carbs give you energy, they help you recover, they're good for you. They say carbs should be half your diet, so put that in your pipe and smoke it. I say carbs, 1 gram to 1.5 grams of your body weight. I do about like 150 grams of carbs on a regular active day. On a high active day, I'm at like 200 grams of carbs. That's when I'm like trying to maintain my weight or eating out of surplus. It really makes a huge difference in your performance and in your gains, and even in like weight loss and fat loss. Like, it's really weird if you just stick to the plan. If you're active and you work out a lot and you're cutting carbs, girlfriend, boyfriend, good luck to you. So next is fat and sugar. So these are very minimal in my diet. Sugar, I'm pretty much eating like fruit in the beginning of the day with like my oatmeal. And then fat, anywhere from like 40 to 50 grams a day, if that. Like, I'm really like not an expert on like fat, but avocado, peanut butter, once a day, don't overdo it. It's kind of my rule of thumb. Cut the sweet treats. Oh my gosh, sugar, alcohol. PSA, if you drink every night, if you drink every weekend, let me offer you the biggest piece of advice. Stop. Stop drinking. Watch yourself lose Wait, alcohol has a lot of sugar in it and a lot of carbs. Be careful. Moving on. The fourth thing is going to be to track your food. So this is kind of where the next step comes in. It's like, okay, so how do I figure out all of this like macros stuff? If you go onto that website and you type in all your information, they give you the calorie count, you figure out what works best for you. Now you have a parameter for how much protein and carbs you should be able to eat throughout the day. And those should be your benchmarks. Once you start adding in food that you can eat and making sure it fits your macros, you'll be able to see how many calories you're eating, what exactly your macros look like. And you know, your protein and carbs should be like about the same. Protein might be a little bit more or carbs is a little bit more. But they should be like, honestly, almost like dead even. Fats and sugars should be really low, and then your calories should match what science recommends. I'm going to actually list out in the description and also in my blog post a list of macro-friendly foods that I think are really easy to switch in and out. You guys can pick and choose if those are the ones you want to use, but it's a good place to get started. Seems a little overwhelming at first to figure all that out, but I promise that once you figure out what your macros look like, once it's all filled out, it's really easy to switch in and out of food all the time. You guys just do it the one time, then you can switch in and out of food. My last tip is consistency is key, but please don't let counting calories ruin or run your life. Be consistent with your macros. Get in the swing of things. Eat according to your plan. Track your food. Get into a groove. Get excited. Get fired up. Find someone that wants to do it with you. When the day comes and you want to have a cheat day, plan it out. Get excited about it, but don't overindulge. That way you can feel a little bit more confident about, you know, still staying on your diet and really feeling like you earned that cheat day. It's always a really good feeling. Yay for good feelings. Those are my 5 tips on how to get back on track. Understanding food, I really recommend following those steps. They've worked for me. I eat great. I feel my body. I have energy all the time. It's all about what you put in your body. The working out is awesome, but it does all come down to food and what you put in your body. I really hope you guys were able to learn something from this. I hope that I've answered a lot of questions that I've been getting. And if I didn't, just write me in the comments or message me on Instagram at @solamentesosh. And if you haven't already, please subscribe, like, comment, share it with a friend. I really look forward to hearing the response, and I hope everyone has a lovely week. Bye.